Perkisah juga ya.
Encik Perempat, boleh cerita sikit mengenai pengalaman kisah di sebalik jadi pesakit Perkisah?
Hello and good morning. Saya cakap Melayu lah. Sebenarnya saya dah lama kena penyakit ni. Saya lahir dah kena dah. Saya nak makan pun tak boleh. Tahu tak? Saya nak makan, nak masuk mulut, masuk hidung. Banyak benda saya tak boleh buat. Jadi saya harapkanlah sumbangan-sumbangan masjid pun. Harapkan sumbangan anda semua lah.
Okay, cepat kata, siapa yang menjadi tonggak boleh adapt dengan kehidupan ini sekarang?
Apa dia?
Okay, yang menjadi awak boleh hidup sampai sekarang. So, tak putus asa walaupun
menghidapi sakit. Saya dapat bantuan daripada NGO. Saya dapat bantuan daripada medik Mesir. Lagi saya dapat bantuan dari masjid-masjid surau-surau dan daripada keluarga saya sendiri. Saya terus bertahan hingga ke akhir. Itulah.
Okay, and that's all from Encik Perempuan. Thank you so much. Okay, now we're going to proceed with Dr. Ryan or Dr. Rai. So he's going to talk about risk factor. Yeah,
sorry. Assalamualaikum untuk yang itu. I am a doctor. I'm going to speak English. Okay. I'm going to talk about the risk factors of Parkinson's disease. Actually, the actual factor of Parkinson is still unknown, but some researchers had done some research to know the probable causes of the factors of Parkinson's disease. There is some factors that I will explain. Firstly is age. According to a research, the common patient that had Parkinson is among 60s, and the, most likely the symptoms will develop at the early 50s. The second factor is gender. According to Prof. Asfar, but the male is likely to have double risk to get Parkinson's disease. And third is family history. Having a parent or sibling that have a Parkinson's disease will cause you to have higher risk of getting Parkinson's. But actually, it's not that true. It's just a research. And lastly, is medication. You know, some people take medication and some of them will overdose. So this overdose thing will cause people to most likely get Parkinson's disease. Yes, that's all.
Okay, I see. Okay, thank you so much, Dr. Roy. So now let us follow by Dr. Dane. He's a neurologist in Hospital Surabaya. So he's going to talk about clinical manifestation. It's almost like about signs and symptoms. Yes, you can listen.
Okay, welcome. Thank you, Iman. Okay, I am a doctor, you know, I am specialist, so please listen to me. Okay, actually, we have four main signs and symptoms of this Parkinson's disease. The first one is actually tremor. Tremor is actually, simply to understand, actually involuntary shaking. Mostly happen in hand and caused by the loss of relax and contract of muscle. So for example, Parkinson's disease, the person with Parkinson's disease will have trouble putting the, you know, thread in the needle, and also putting the eye drop. Because they are shaking, you know. And more specifically, the tremor is actually the resting tremor, which is the tremor only happen when the hand is at rest. When the hand is, you know, moving, the tremor will stop. So next is actually rigidity. The rigidity means the really stiff muscle, which actually will cause cogwheel rigidity, which is a jerky movement. For example, I can give when a person with the Parkinson's disease want to grab a food to his mouth, he will jerky like this.
Can I control on his hand?
Yes. The smooth movement will not occur. So next is actually slow movement. Slow movement in science term, we call it bradykinesia. Brandy means slow, kinesia means movement. So actually, slow movement will cause weakness, fatigue, and inability to move body parts. Like slow movement, for example, you remember the last time you go to swimming pool or sea, when you want to run in the water, you feel very slow. That is actually shows the slow movement. Okay, next is postural instability. The person with Parkinson's disease will very unstable and unbalanced when they stand up. In the brain, we have postural reflex, which is help the balance. So in Parkinson's disease, the postural reflex is not working. So the person will not be balanced when they walk. So postural instability happen actually later in the disease. So the initial time when the person get the disease, the person will not experiencing postural instability. So the later, the person will have. So the person will hard to walk around and will fall when walk. So that's all.
Okay, so that's all from Dr. Day. He's saying about the sign and symptoms. So for those who don't know yet, but this can digest all this. And so now we're going to have some break for a while. So those audience at home and also in the studio can relax first and go to the toilet or anything. Okay. Let's proceed with phone in session, where our audience at home can call us on number 011-0698426. It's like we are having our caller. Okay, hello.
Hello.
Okay, who's there? Okay, that's all. Is that your patient, honey? Okay, thank you. Thank you, Okay, the patient is from NTRS1. He's asking us about the test and analysis. Okay, can you please talk to Dean to explain to us about it?
Okay, thank you to Rizwan for asking me. So I will explain again on the diagnosis of the Parkinson's disease. Okay, basically there are no lab tests can confirm the disease. There is no blood test or urine test because there is no abnormality in the blood. or the urine that Parkinson's disease do. So there is one way to diagnose Parkinson's disease, which is to look at the physical of the person. So we can, first thing, we can look for the clinical history, which is we will ask the patients about the history of his life. So what are the thing that the patient has been experiencing? Maybe when we ask, he will say that he has been experiencing tremor, or more specifically resting tremor. Or maybe he will say that he has been experiencing stiff muscle, yes. Or maybe trouble in his initiating movement, like I just said just now. So other than that, actually we very need to ask the patient how long and how the actually problem happened to him. If the person say that he suddenly woke up in the morning, then the problem happened, we can consider that that is not Parkinson's disease, because actually Parkinson's disease is a progressive disease, which is will happen slowly. It will not happen suddenly. So we will also can test the sense of smell, which is Parkinson's disease will affect the sense of smell, and also the memory concentration. We will ask something about his or her memory, and we will look if he can concentrate directly to the memory. So the family, actually the family history is also important, because there will be a gene mutation if the family history the other family has the Parkinson's disease also. So next we will also can diagnose with a neurological exam, which is we will look in front of our eye how the person having the problem. So we will ask him or her to walk, and we will see if the person has a balance movement, or he will slow to stand maybe, or he cannot pull her arm smoothly, and others. So besides that, we will also do an imaginary test, such as MRI or brain ultrasound test, which is can cross out the other illness. Actually, we cannot see the Parkinson's disease in the imaginary test, but we can cross out the other illness. So we will also can give the person medication, which is we will see if the medication works for him or her. So we will confirm that there is Parkinson's disease. We also will follow up with the patient. We with doing appointment, so we will very confirm that there is Parkinson's disease.
Okay, that's from Dr. Day. So those who feel like having signs or symptoms for Parkinson's disease can go for check up to for Dr. A doctor. Okay. So now we're going to proceed with Dr. Sofia Masara. He's pursuing study in Master in Medicine Neurology in University of Park Island. So he's going to talk about treatment and management. Okay, you can start.
Okay, thank you to Iman as his MC in our program, and a very good evening to everyone. What I'm talking about is about treatment to Parkinson's disease. As we know that Parkinson's disease do not have the real medications. So if the patient with Parkinson's disease can be treated, like it can consume caffeine, which appear to protect against Parkinson's disease. And the second one is tobacco smoke is found to reduce the risk of PD is a short form for Parkinson's disease. And third one is antioxidants such as vitamin C and D also can reduce risk.
Meaning that there's no prevention at all. I mean that we can only cure it just to, you know, like taking medication only, not slightly through all the Parkinson's disease.
We have it, but we need to do a surgery to the patients. Okay. As we know that vitamin C is can reduce inflammation to the patients. Act as antioxidants, which can protect cell from getting damaged, and it also regulates neurotransmitter productions. That means it increases the production of neurotransmitter. And it also has the preliminary indicator of a possible protection role of estrogen and anti-inflammatory drugs. Okay. I just showing the first history of Parkinson's disease. First, the first one who was diagnosed of Parkinson's disease is Pampavata. She was the one who was he was the one who create Indian medication system in Ayurveda. Do you know is Ayurveda? Okay, Ayurveda. If you know that it was a history of medication in India that we study in history in Form 4. Okay, then it was shocking possibly diagnosed by Galen's and. In year of 1817, he was described symptoms. James Parkinson, that means James Parkinson, who created the Parkinson disease. Okay, and last one in 1997, polymeropoulos is a gene mutation. Was discovered. That means during 1997, part one was diagnosed with gene mutation was discovered.
Thank you, Dr. Masara. So now we're going to have Q&A session for the audience in the studio. So is there any volunteer? You are there? introduce yourself first.
Hello, my name is Izani. And I would like to ask Dr. Ryan a question.
Okay.
Doctor, could you please explain how we can prevent Parkinson's disease?
Okay.
Thank you.
Actually, like I said earlier, there is no known main factors for the Parkinson's disease. So actually, I had researched some ways to prevent Parkinson's disease based on Google Chrome, and I found that actually the key to prevent Parkinson's disease is lead a healthy lifestyle. And as a Muslim, you know, pray is a weapon. So if you pray every day, inshallah, you can prevent. Yes, it's all about me.
Okay, but actually, I want to ask a question. What if the person, okay, do not like veggies? What are the other way to, you know, to gain that nutrients? Okay, is it like supplement?
Oh, actually, for me, I also don't like eat vegetable. So what I do is, I eat supplement that tastes like chicken but has been made for vegetable. Yes.
Okay, yeah. Okay, so now we're going to prevention. Yeah. Okay, so that's all for today's TV program. So the conclusion is we cannot differentiate between we cannot have any, there's no slight difference between Parkinson's disease patient and as normal patient, normal person. Okay, that's all. But wait, actually we have a video. but it cannot be played right now in the slide. So can I take some time to play right now?
Later.
Thank you so much, Sarah and Charles.